Welcome back to News Channel 5 at 6. George Mallet, Stephanie Gorin. Today was the last day in business for a landmark in a small Windsor County town. The owners say they just couldn't afford to keep their store open any longer.
And now this Vermont community is hoping someone will fill the void. News Channel 5's Jack Thurston reports.
Barnard, Vermont is one of those towns Norman Rockwell would have painted. It's home to Silver Lake, a tiny post office, and no stoplights. Fewer than 1,000 people live here, and a lot of them are making sure to say thank you this week to Kim Furlong and Carolyn DeChico.
This has been an amazing 18 years for us.
They're the latest owners of the Barnard General Store, the community's one market, opened in 1832 when Andrew Jackson was president.
You have to do what you have to do.
But 18 decades later, the couple shut down the business Tuesday.
This is sad. It is really hard to be the ones that are closing the doors on an institution that's been here for 180 years, never having its door closed.
They blame the economic downturn and rise in internet shopping. Plus, when Tropical Storm Irene washed out Route 107 through neighboring Bethel and Stockbridge last year, tourist traffic slowed way down for months.
The final nail in the store's coffin may have been winter. Little snowfall meant fewer visits from snowmobilers and skiers traveling through.
Two blows in a row is very hard to recover from.
Customers will now have to drive 15 or 20 minutes round trip just to pick up a gallon of milk. They'll also lose a major social center.
It's part of the community.
You know, it's like your right arm, so to speak. You would assume that you would not go anywhere without your right arm because it's kind of attached. So I think it's kind of like the right arm of... of Barnard.
The Vermont Grocers Association says there are about 70 or 80 of these historic general stores left in the state. Many are thriving, but have needed to reinvent themselves.
Going to the next level and trying to figure that out, it's not always easy.
The owners hope someone will come up with a fresh business plan and reopen the Barnard General Store soon. For now, though, they're looking forward to having lighter schedules and more flexibility with their business closed.
Financially, we walk away in debt, but it's money. That's not what's important. You know, the good karma we've built, I swear, is going to sustain us for the rest of our lives.
In Barnard, Jack Thurston, News Channel 5.